Joe Biden is leading this morning in the final four battleground states. So how is Fox TV, the network that has amplified President Trump's message for 4 years, how are they framing the results? Let's take a look at some of Fox's coverage over the past couple of days.
It seems inevitable that in this initial vote count, that Joe Biden is going to win.
The Trump campaign has said that they wanted to have their poll watchers there, and that I guess they're being asked to provide evidence for something that they say they weren't able to even participate in or to be able to see. And so that's, I think, where they would say that needs to be rectified, if it could be.
That's not true. It's not true. It's just not true. The election poll watchers, they are called canvas watchers. Republicans have been in this room, in that room, where they're supposed to be, standing alongside with the Democrats.
When they are talking the fraud issue and they are talking, you know, irregularities, illegalities, what are they specifically referring to?
Neil, I think you're right on target. You see a lot of passion and a lot of anger, but you don't see any specific examples of where was the irregularity.
At this point, the president needs to win at least 3 recounts to even get to 270 or maybe tie it at 269. It's a really tough uphill battle.
To all you patriots who supported President Trump, stand tall and be proud of your efforts and his. It was all worth it. We all helped reshape the national conversation on China, on immigration, on trade, and political correctness, et cetera, et cetera. We don't have time to bury our heads in crying towels.
Let's bring in CNN chief media correspondent Brian Stelter. Brian, wasn't that interesting to see the real reporters,
yes,
Eric Shawn, Steve Harrigan, have to shoot down the hosts by saying, that's not true. That's simply not true. I mean, they're on the ground. They're doing the real reporting, but you can see the kind of, schizophrenic take on what's happening over there.
I think this is a giant tug of war, and it's so important because President Trump is watching this happen. He's watching TV all day, and tens of millions of American voters have their minds influenced by the coverage on Fox. Fox is in the middle of a giant tug of war right now. One minute, Sean Hannity is yelling about voter fraud, but the next minute, Laura Ingraham is talking about the Trump presidency in the past tense. Some of the news anchors have been gently pushing back at these ridiculous voter fraud claims. Others have been letting it slide on the air. I do think on Friday, Allison, we started to see a tone shift at Fox. There was more skepticism toward Trump. And I think Laura Ingraham's commentary last night, where she talked about grace and conceding with grace, that was hugely significant. That was a message directly through the camera to the president. I know it's wild, but we're in this world where these stars on Fox try to communicate to the president through the camera.
And
that's also happening in print. The Wall Street Journal editorial board, also owned by Rupert Murdoch, is sending the same message right now.
Look, I agree it's all interesting what Fox and the Murdoch empire does, but they don't get to decide who the president is. The American people get to decide who the president is, and the voters get to decide who the president is. And we'll figure out soon enough what the voters want here, maybe even by noon today. I will also tell you, Brian, I think the White House knows which way the voters are leaning right now, how this is going. Why? Because they've disappeared. We haven't seen anybody really from inside the White House for more than 24 hours. Why do you think that is?
Well, I called it a tug of war. I think a tug of war is happening in the White House as well. Think about the end of a football game. Think about the end of any sporting event. Sometimes the last minute is the most important. Sometimes the last minute is the only minute you remember. And I think these White House staffers are wondering, how am I going to be remembered? How is this president going to be remembered? And that's been the rhetoric on Fox, by the way. How is your presidency going to be remembered? You know, yesterday we reported that some staffers at Fox were told to stay away from the term president-elect when Biden crosses the 270 mark. After we reported that here on CNN, there was internal angst about that idea. There was backlash. And then anchors on Fox started to, in hypothetical conversations, refer to Biden as president-elect. This tug of war is happening at Fox and at the White House right now. And it's understandable that some staffers don't want to be caught up in the president's lies on Twitter, his lies about voter fraud. By the way, you know, he has been labeled on Twitter many, many times this week for bogus lies. We've never seen that before. These platforms, these networks, are taking a stand right now.
Brian Stelter, please keep us posted. I expect we'll hear more from them over the next several hours.